I was never super happy with a profile picture, but it was better than nothing. I was afraid it could give the wrong associations. Ho ho ho. I changed to this one, which is ridiculous enough, but I'm still looking. Anyways, here comes the real content today. Hello YouTube. Well, have you seen? There is a bit of surface rust on the table here. I think it comes from the cutting fluid I bought the last time here. I'm not too happy with it. I've seen it. It often comes between the device and the table. I get some surface rust here. Anyways, this video is not about rust. It is about this pendant or MPG. MPG, manual pulse generator. So it generates pulses. Pulse. Pendant, I don't know what that is. This is an old model. They don't sell it anymore. Perhaps you can find an old one, but there is another one that is the current model, so to say. I have used it several years. I'm very happy with it. I like this a lot. All when I meal, I sit like this. My thumb is on the stop button or pause button, and I have the feel right here, so I adjust that up and down. So I think this one worked great. It has lived a tough life. The rubber feet here, they are gone since long time. There are magnets here, so they pick up all the chips and so. But they are pretty easy to brush away. I dropped it in the floor several times. Usually what happens is that this knob here bend a little bit here. This can also bend a little bit, but that is... you kind of put it back. But the last time, this knob here broke. And then I have an Allen key there, pushed in there. I've kept it like this under the radar, but this is what it looks like. I will fix it, or I will have to buy a new one. Or, well, that is a new model then, but why not give it a try to fix it? Let's go up to the sofa. I lost the cover to the battery compartment. Made a new one. Still looks up. I'm a bit amazed over that. There we have it. But this board needs to go away. Oh. This switch isn't all that common. I have searched the internet for hours almost until I found it close by, and I have ordered one. So it's on the way. So in the meantime, I will try to get this off here. So it is soldered here, five pins and two holders, one for the casing. Yeah, it needed some persuasion there, but here it is. It's loose. Cleaned up the PCB here. It looks fine. That should be no problem to put in a new one there. And here is this one. And after a week, here is a new switch inside there, of course. And I could have gotten it much quicker if it hadn't been for DHL Express that sat for it for half a week. And then when they were about to deliver it, they asked me, do you want it delivered? And then it took 4 more days. Thank you guys at DHL Express. Oh yeah, but now I have it. I have to go and pick it up at the depot. Let's see here. So I ordered 2 of them. It took quite some effort to find it. might stretch my googling skills, I must say. But I think it looks alright. It should be alright. We should just see if it is the one. I hope it is. If it looks alright. Let me go into details of what it is I have got. No, it sure looks right. Yeah, I think this is fine. I have compared it on paper. So I'll tell you what I bought. I got it from this place, tme.eu, but it is available on many more places. This is the one I bought. It took me an hour or maybe even 2 hours to find out what this type of switch is called and give it a name so I could order it. It didn't cost too much, less than $2. This switch may not be so common. I was happy to find one after a few hours googling, but once I have found it and ordered it and paid for it, I found another one. This one from Alps Technology, and I think this one is exactly the same one. And this is available everywhere. You find it on eBay, you find it on AliExpress, and it costs almost nothing. So if you plan to break this switch as I did here, you can order this one in advance. So you have it and don't need to wait for it. Anyways, enough of talking. I will have to put it into the PCB and we will get on with it. I thought the switch I got was mirrored, but it helped immensely to put it on the right side. It should be on the downside here. A little problem is that those there, whatever they are now called, that comes from the casing, they are in the way a bit there, so I will cut them off. Because I still need to adjust the height there. So that's how it should be. And if we compare towards original, then I hope it was the same. There is a tab there that sticks out. I have to fix that too. That cannot be there. Or can it? No. To line up those pins there. But it shouldn't be a problem really. There, as far as I can see, yes. And we had a number of screws there. I can already now say that that switch I bought isn't the perfect one. It is an 8 position switch. And you need a 7 position switch, so I think that that Alps switch is a better choice if you happen to want to buy one. So they all have the same pin now. It is just that there are 8 positions, and so I will have one now. I will have one off switch before the 6 active positions, so to say. That was for the 4 channels and feed and speed. And then if I turn it a little bit more, then there will be one off switch again. Off position again. I don't think it matters, but of course it... Yeah, okay. It's always nice to do it right, of course. So don't buy that Ninigi or whatever it is called. It's difficult to use names there. So I think I'm officially missing one then. There could be one. Yeah, so I cannot find it. So I think I will have to continue. So I have to tighten this one up here, because that will set the position and the height, so to say, of the switch. It should not be right against the PCB, it should be hover one millimeter above that. That is the point. So let's say that. So off, X, Y, Z, A, spindle feed, and there is one additional off there. So that's okay. It's not like original, so maybe it's an improvement then. It will not be better than that, but I think that will be right. So I'm a little bit disturbed by that I lost that screw there, so I will have to go back to the video and see if I actually had a screw there or what happened. Now, I think this one will not respond before it has contact with the transmitter. I'm going to arrange that. So I now have that transmitter in a USB power supply. It's not connected to a computer or anything, so I think it should work now. Yeah, it is. And it is now in the off switch. I wonder if it works. It clicked anyway, so yeah, that should be the X. Could be right. Y. Could be right. Z could be right. No, it should be A. Come on. It is A. Yeah, so this has worked. Yes, and feed for spindle and the speed. And so this was an 8 position, but the original it was only a 7 position. So this should be an off position again. I guess that is off, yeah. So I think it worked. Yeah, great project. I need a knob there, a decent knob there. I should just try to 3D print one then, I think. So I have to have some more tools. It should go on there. Maybe. Yeah, it does. Press fit. But I have prepared a set screw, actually, so I'll see if I can get that in there. So I managed to find one set screw here, one M3 set screw there. Oh, I have some more Allen keys. I don't think they are called Allen keys now when I have them like this one. Anyways. That is so tight that is all right. But then I will have it like that. I think it is a little bit, it has a little bit larger diameter than before, I feel. No, it is all right, but I get stuck with my thumb being there, and I didn't do that before. So I'll see if I can make a smaller diameter again. And a new knob. Hopefully the last one I will make. I changed the set screw there to M4 instead. I think that's it then. Yes, 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 yes. This is so good. It sticks out a little bit there, and it should do that. So, I think this worked fine. It was a great project. Thanks for watching, everyone. It always feels good to succeed like this. Great. Yeah.